Hello, this is Tony of Tonish Music and the creator of Design and Create in Facebook, and I'm on Affinity Designer version 2, and I'm just going to open an A4 document, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to create the Element Circle video for you and show you how it was made and make this tutorial for you. And this is part one of three parts to this video, right? This is the part one, right? And in this one, it's about making the circle and sorting one out. So if we do the circle first, like that, somewhere in there, right? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a style to it, a gold style, that one, and then I'm going to change it to the stroke effect. So I'm going to improve on the stroke effect to about 30.5, like that. See quite easily now, and I'm going to try and do some so that it's the same thing as possible. Set it that way, centralised it. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to add quick effects to make the 3D image a bit more 3D-ish by adding the radius to it to make it more 3D, yeah, like that. Then I'm going to add two rectangular pieces, one to go that way, if I can, and make sure that's right, I can see a minute. Oops, it's gone too far now. Try that again, edit window transform, so with them two I can get the layers. Click bar for them, and now I want to change their effect on their 3D for them, so it's similar. Right, now I've done that, what I'm going to do next is get another circle. Now I'll copy the circle that's on there, copy that circle by clicking it, copy, and then paste on that, and then I'm going to go to colour, flip the fill and the stroke onto over so that I'll have that. Change that to bright green by doing that, and then I'm going to put that at the back. I'm going to move that to the back like so. Right, so I've done all that. Now the last thing to do is get a rectangular shape and put it right on the background all the way along. This rectangular shape has got a bit of a colour to the green inside there. I'm going to change it to pink, and then I'm going to arrange that at the back as well. pack, and there's a good reason for doing this, and I'll show you in a bit. But at the moment, that is all you've got to do for part one, except for this last bit, which is make sure you select all. Click on there. Always click on the move too before you select all, because you might not select all else. And if you have a look on the layers, check it to make sure it's got everything. Once you've done that, file, export. Right. If you've got it select all and selection only, if you've got any transparency parts in there, it will not add the background that was the actual document itself. It will just what you've selected, right? So I've done that. Now what I need to do is make sure pixels are 1920 by 180. Okay, take that like that, and I'm going to export that. Right, so I'll make sure that's imported as tutorial. Tutorial circle is now saved onto my desktop over there. I'll fit it there. It's going to be wide, but don't worry about that. You're going to worry about that, so it's okay. Right, so I've done that. Now I'm going to click off that, and that's at the end of part one. Hello and welcome to part two of the Element Circle video tutorial. I'm Tony, of Tony's Music and the Creative Design Create Facebook group. And I'm going to go into Movavi Video Suite, and I'm on the video editor. And what I've done is I've just added the files that I need for this part. So you've got your background, which is space. That is only going to be used for reference in this particular part, but I'll show you what I do. I just put it in there like that, and now I'm going to reference how long it takes to do the whole video with that, right, for the moment, by using it as a scaler. And what I want to do is I want to make sure how much of the file I want to keep and how much I want to cut. So that's the bit I want from there. So I'm just going to cut that off there and remove this piece because I don't want that. Right, now we've got that piece. All I need to do is copy that and paste it until I get to the end of where that is. So I'm just paste it, paste it, add that to there, paste. Crossfades across So now that looks pretty good, that looks right. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to move this outside like that, delete that. Now I've already got the reference on there. Right, so now what I need to do is the same with the rest of it, it's the same length. What I need to reference, I'll make sure I've got the right These are all the same size, and I just need to add the last one, which is the silver. Now what we need to do with this is click on these squares to get the crown key, click off the crown key. That's at the fire. Once you've done that, just click on it and there it is in that area. There you go. The next one, which is the clouds. Push it that way. Up there. There. Bring the top down a bit. Just there. Across here. Okay. And that's that one. The water next. As you can see, they're all in there, and that is how you do this part of the tutorial. So what I need to do now is, now I've done all that, is export it as tutorial. Okay, so I've done that, and I'm going to put that in YouTube preparation. Select that folder. Okay. Save it as 1920x1080. Like that. That should be okay then. Now that's saved, we'll go on to part 3 moment, okay? Hello and welcome to part 3 of the Element Circle video tutorial. And we're back in Movavi Video Suite on the video editor with a new project. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add the files I need, which is the one in YouTube, where I put it on the preparation, and that's tutorial part 2, right? And I also need the background, which I had before but I haven't got it now. So I've got to go back to where I had it from, which was in my video library, somewhere here. There it is, video volume 1, and it's in space. Right, so down to the space ones. Now, what we need to do is first of all use a chroma key on pick, and there you go, right? So now what we need to do is just be able to turn the top one, and in order to do that, we just need the animation, right? Now I need an advanced animation. Start off with that, and you can click on it. The first one we need to do that is disappear into the thing first. Put it in the middle. Oops, hang on, let's go over there. Let's go over there and put it in the middle. Bit fiddly when you're doing that. Just there, like that. Right, and then just so it zooms out. This is what's going to do, it's about to do like that. Right, so watch what can happen. Just there, comes out like that. Right, then we're going to turn it round. So what I do is I do add a keyframe. Add the keyframe. less bass, but I'm just giving you the rough idea of what I did. So it'll move when I need it to. So then I've done the move. Let's go in a quarter. adjust this a little bit because I want it to go just before then, so I can put that bang in. That's what I sort of did, that sort of thing. Okay, so that's how you do that kind of tutorial. I think my circle needed to be a bit thinner so that when I got it out like that, it wouldn't have been so wide. But you know, then things happen when you're trying to teach somebody else how to do it, unfortunately. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, please like and subscribe to Tony's Music. Thank you.